Welcome back for another round of Aquaponics Ask Me Anything. Jessica writes, what's the best aquaponics system for someone like me? I go on vacation all the time and my plants always die. I feel your pain, Jessica, and I think every aquaponic farmer knows that anxiety. Isn't it always when you're on vacation that your pump fails or your emitter falls out of place? For folks who are away from home often, I really recommend using wicking beds for plant production. Wicking beds are sub-irrigated planters, a really great low-tech solution for aquaponic growers that can actually go weeks in between waterings. I actually have wicking beds at the greenhouse here on campus and at home because I love how low maintenance they are. Monica's question, how to start seeds in aquaponics? What are those little plug thingies people put their seeds in? Some look like soil. Are they soil? So some aquaponic farmers actually do use potting soil to start their seeds. But it's more common for aquaponic farmers to use different forms of stabilized media. These plugs are designed specifically for use in propagation and hydroponics. Some stabilized media, like the Q-plug we use here on campus, are made from organic matter glued together with a binding agent. Other plugs, like these Jiffy 7 pellets, are made up of organic matter held in a biodegradable pouch. There's also stabilized media made from minerals. Rock wool is made from weaving fibers of superheated rock together into a lightweight, waterproof material. These stabilized media are so popular because they don't leave debris in our system. That debris can cause problems later on if it gunks up our pumps or our pipes. I hope that was helpful, Monica. Should I do a whole video on plug thingies? David wants to know, what's the most expensive food grown in aquaponics? Now this will be different for everyone, depending on your unique climate, growing conditions, and what's legal to grow in your area. Here in the Golden State, we have two aquaponic cash crops that are pound for pound, two of the most expensive crops grown anywhere in the world. Legal recreational cannabis is a multi-billion dollar industry that is more and more often employing aquaponics as a sustainable cultivation tool. But what's even more expensive than cannabis? Caviar. Here in California, we produce 90% of North America's caviar, and producers like Tsar Nikolai Caviar have turned to aquaponics as a way to convert their waste effluent into fresh produce. Tsar Nikolai's crown jewel retails for just under $10,000 per kilogram, making caviar the most expensive food grown in aquaponics in California. Want more information on aquaponic systems? You're gonna wanna watch this video here. And remember to leave your questions about aquaponics down in the comments for our next edition of Aquaponics Ask Me Anything. I'm Nathan Kaufman from UC Davis. This has been Aquaponics Ask Me Anything.